I would say with less than a minute from us arriving there, if we didn't get that rope on in the first attempt, we weren't getting a second attempt at it. It's as straightforward as that. Been involved with RNLI now for over 23 years, maybe actually nearly 25. You lose count after 20. Just passed out as coxswain back in December. So this was my first call out as coxswain. It's certainly not what I'd planned for my first shout. Thought it'd be a nice, flat, calm night. Maybe a little yacht needing assistance into the bay. It didn't quite turn out that way. It was quite tough getting out of the harbour due to it being an easterly gale and Peterhead's on the east coast. As soon as we were actually letting go of our ropes, we heard the communications on the radio from the skipper and knew by the tone of his voice that things were getting desperate. So it was a sort of balancing act between sticks flat down, knowing I had guys in the back of the boat wanting them to get the tow rope prepped before we got there, because we'd all seen what like the conditions was going to be. And there we saw the boat, yeah, just quite a mile in front of us. Thought she was actually on the rocks at that point. But looked very close. We immediately requested that the helicopter be launched. I really didn't think we would be able to get a line on, one, with where she was, and two, with the conditions, just like a washing machine in the corner of the breakwater it was. So on arrival, it was just a first thing I was doing, just a quick look. Couldn't go around the boat because it was so close inshore, too much breaking waves. Just a quick look to check there was no lines from the previous tow attempt that could end up funning us up. And then it was a case of trying to get the lifeboat turned around into the wind, knowing that we'd one opportunity. So I tried to get the boat positioned as best we could, make a not a run for it, but to get as close as we could, pretty much without damaging both boats. The video footage sort of shows it all. Slightly different when you were there, I can assure you. So I was just watching the guy that caught the rope, making sure, and I knew once he had it fast, he was giving me arms and hand signals. And yeah, with the way his arms was moving, I knew he wanted me to start pulling. And at that point, just got all my guys on deck, just to clear out the road, being a safe area. It was almost taking full power of the engines just to stop it from going astern. And then once we got some momentum going, yeah, pretty much just sort of feathering the throttles, praying that the tow line wouldn't part, you know. Can't really say no more than that. It all happened so fastly. I've just seen the opening. I did radio the boat in the harbour and said, listen, I think the safest option here is we just try and get you straight into the bay. We don't go and try and go offshore and be set up another tow. We just go for it. I think from being departing the berth to getting the tow on, it was 9 minutes, something like that. So it was extremely great. The whole operation was over within the hour. Probably about 10, 15 minutes maybe of towing, just to get it safely into the harbour. And then three harbour tugs took over, just to put it alongside the quay. The skipper was on the radio many a time we were in the bay, thanking us so much for what we'd done. And yeah, so that's what we trained for. We were just really pleased we got there in time and we've got them all back in. It's not only people's lives, it's our livelihoods as well. So, I mean, yeah, the whole crew were sort of humbled. It's not until after you look back and sit and think about it, you go, wow, that was close. Don't want to be in that situation again. For me as a crew member and the rest of the crew, it's fantastic to see the positive support that we're getting. And it makes you think, yeah, people do appreciate what we do. The public have been, it's phenomenal the amount of views some of these videos has gotten, and some of the donations that's came through as well. I mean, we can't thank them enough. As I say, gives us a bit of pride. Yeah. I've been in the boat for many years. Yeah, it just hits back. That feeling of knowing that you've done something good. For the community, and you've potentially saved some people's lives. Yeah, it doesn't get any better than that, you know, it makes it all worthwhile.